I'm Dave Cappelleri, and this is the world's smallest drum. So the world's smallest drum that we printed is 47 microns in diameter. So for reference, a human hair is about 100 microns in diameter. So the diameter of the drum is about half the size of the diameter of human hair. So it's hard to see this with the naked eye, so you need to use a special microscope called a scanning electron microscope in order to zoom in and actually see the drum. And you can see very high resolution, not only the outside diameter of the drum, but also the writing of the world's smallest drum that you see inside there. My research group is working on microrobotics, so really small gripping microrobots. We fabricate swimming microrobots with little helical tails, tumbling microrobots as well. So it's very challenging how to fabricate these robots. I'm always looking at new technology that we can acquire and use in order to build these microrobots. So there's lots of different kinds of 3D printers that you will see, some that hobbyists can have on their desk. There are also more sophisticated, high-resolution 3D printers that are out there. And so in order to build really small structures using 3D printing technology, we need to use a special kind of 3D printer. Instead of having filament, we actually have a photosensitive resin and a laser. And then the laser can very finely polymerize small regions of that photoresist to make these very small parts. So we acquired this 3D printer and we're trying to see its capabilities and what we can do to push the boundaries. The world's largest drum here at Purdue, so thought, hey, it would be really great if we can use their 3D printer to print the world's smallest drum, really showcase its abilities. We're very excited to get the record from Guinness for the world's smallest drum. It was quite a process of documenting everything, submitting all the paperwork and videos, and it got experts to verify everything. And so when we finally got the news, we're really excited and we're happy to share it with the world. So we talk a lot about giant leaps here at Purdue, really great progress that we're making, but sometimes a giant leap can be very small, maybe as small as 47 microns.